if you guys have followed me for any length of time, wherever, whether it's YouTube, Instagram, my blog, then you know I am certifiably crazy about tulips and spring bulbs in general. And apparently flowerbulbs.com knew that too, because they approached me about doing a little project with them to really help promote the wonders and the miracles of planting spring bulbs in the fall. So I'm doing such a fun project, you guys. One thing I love to do is give spring flowering bulbs as a gift. And so this year, in addition to planting thousands of my own, I am also giving away all sorts of spring blooming bulbs to some of my friends. Some of them are getting them for Christmas gifts. Some of them are getting them for birthday gifts. This one is a housewarming gift. And what I've done is put it together. She moved in not too long ago, and I know the facade of her house, and I know what color she likes. So I have selected a blend of tulips in red and yellow that I think she will just absolutely love. And I'm going to surprise her with this basket. Now, I took them out of the box and put them in this basket for a specific reason. Number one, just because it looks really, really pretty, and I've lined it in some vibrant kitchen towels that make it look especially festive in colors that I know she likes. I've added a couple of pairs of garden gloves because she is really trying to teach her granddaughter about gardening and planting bulbs. So I've put a couple of pair of garden gloves in there for both of them. But I'm also putting them in this shallow basket for really practical reasons. So here is a bulb planting tip. When I plant bulbs, I try to put them in a large container that's really shallow. And why I do that is because when I'm on my hands and knees and I'm planting lots of tulips, I don't want to continually reach up and over a really tall box or into any kind of really tall container to get the bulbs. I just want to be able to kind of scoop them into the ground. And so I have learned after 30 years of planting masses and masses of bulbs that's a really important consideration. It's just kind of a common sense thing, but one that I try to remember every year. And this basket will be perfect for that. She can just dump the bulbs into the basket, and then she can just kind of tip the basket over, put the bulbs in place. And also, one other tip is I don't typically ever do this one bulb at a time kind of thing. I am practically always planting them in moss where they make the most dramatic statement. And it doesn't matter if they're tulips like these, or daffodils, or hyacinths, or muscari, any kind of bulb, I think, to really make a dramatic show needs to be planted in large quantities. And no matter where you get your bulbs, whether it's from an online source, whether it's from your local garden center or nursery, it really doesn't matter. But typically, you can get a pretty large quantity of bulbs for a very moderate price, especially if you buy them online in large quantities. And that's what I do every year. Now, here's another kind of tip. I have noticed that some of the online sources have a lot of their bulbs on sale right now, and probably also your local nursery. So they're on sale right now. Whatever is still available is a great bargain, because some of them are as much as 50% off. So it's not too late. It's not too late to plant them. In my Zone 7 garden, I can plant, actually it's still a little bit early for me. I usually wait until the week before Thanksgiving, and then I've got a long window of time, all the way up until the end of December, to get my bulbs in the ground. Now, obviously for you guys, depending on where you garden and what zone you're in, you wanna do it before the ground freezes on a day that's nice or whatever. But for us here in Zone 7 gardens, we still have a long window of time to plant. And so the timing on this will be really perfect. Now, I know she doesn't know what she's getting. I do know that she is home today, and I do know because I did a little prefatory sleuthing. I asked her what color she was planning on using in front of her house now that it's a different color brick and that kind of thing. So I know she'll really like these colors, and they'll also look beautiful against her red brick home. So I think it's really fun. Another thing that I think is especially meaningful, bulbs make a great gift for people that you know that already have pretty much everything, because no one wants to turn down a spring show of flowering bulbs in their front yard in you know, next year. It's something for them to look forward to. So for my mother-in-law, for her birthday, which was always in November, I would always give her bulbs as a gift. Back when I wasn't so busy, I would also offer to plant them for her. So you get extra credit if you give not only the bulbs, but you give a gift certificate to plant them as well. Or if you don't have time, sometimes if I'm giving it to someone whom I know just can't plant them themselves, or are too elderly or maybe infirm, they can't plant them themselves, then I will sometimes give a gift certificate of a landscaper or a gardener who will plant them for them. So it's really, really fun. Also, if it's a new gardener and you know they have never tried planting bulbs before, and if they're intimidated by bulbs and they think they're difficult, this is a perfect learning opportunity from them to teach them how easy it is to plant bulbs. When I plant tulips, I don't even put any additional plant food or anything in the hole, because that's the miracle of a bulb. It's got everything it needs in this tight little package. So it's really easy, much easier than I think new gardeners or inexperienced gardeners think it is to grow a beautiful, beautiful bulb display. If you know somebody who just absolutely love fragrance, give them a basket of hyacinth bulbs, because there is just no better gift, I think, than to give them the anticipation of something that is going to bloom in spring. So that's, I guess, my big tip for today. Consider giving flower bulbs as a gift to someone, whether it's for a housewarming gift, whether it's as a hostess gift. If you're visiting someone over Thanksgiving and going there for Thanksgiving dinner, give them a basket of bulbs. It would be a brilliant idea. If they're a new gardener, as a birthday gift, for whatever reason, I think bulbs in general make a wonderful presentation and a really thoughtful gesture. So that's my tip from me and flowerbulbs.com. Consider giving bulbs as a gift. And here's your outfit of the day. My earrings are Madewell gold hoops. I love these. I love them because they make a real statement, I think. My jacket, I'm so glad it's gotten cool enough that I can finally wear this. It's one of my favorite pieces of fall and winter clothing. It was from Altered State, and I got it on sale. It was like 50% off. It was a great deal, and I love it. And by the way, this faux fur collar is also removable, so I can wear it as more of a traditional blazer if I like. You can't really see my shirt underneath, but it is just a J. Crew, kind of a thin denim-like shirt. I got this at Goodwill. My breeches are Eddie Bauer, and I think I got these at some thrift store. I'm not sure exactly where. My boots are J. Crew, and they are very, very, very comfortable, and I like the fact that they have a pointed, kind of a little bit more delicate look. So there you go. There is my outfit of the day.